Entering the fourth and final round of the Daikin Spirit of America Golf Classic, 11 players were within 5 strokes of the lead. Hartsel grad Sam Murphy held that top position and looked to start strong on Saturday. The Decatur native kept his solid play going early Saturday with a strong tee shot setting up a birdie putt on the first. On the second hole, it's his pair partner Matt Smith nearly saving par. A beautiful chip just misses the cup and he'd have to settle for a bogey. Murphy was the only one in the pairing to par that hole, with his short game keeping him ahead. Some amazing luck saved Will Patrick on the fourth. His tee shot goes wide right of the green, but takes a friendly bounce off a cart path tree, bouncing back onto the green to put him in position for an easy two-putt birdie. In the final pairing, Murphy was cruising through the front seven, but ran into trouble on the eighth, dropping 2 strokes after a penalty gave him a double bogey.
The first 3 days, I missed it left, and I was like, all right, this one, you need to hit the fairway, push a little too hard. Went out of bounds, but I mean, it's golf, like it happens.
A setback that became even more painful when he bogeyed the 10th. All the while, Caleb O'Toole was tearing up the back nine. The Pinson native birdied 4 of the last 9, including 3 straight to overtake Murphy for the lead. Murphy would make a late push, but fall just 2 strokes short as O'Toole captured the championship at 8 under. The Western Kentucky golfer has spent 8 years at this event, even caddying for his brother the year he won, an experience he says carried over to his own victory.
I feel like I learned something from caddying. You know, I try to get something out every time I'm at a golf course, and I learned a lot from my brother caddying, and I just pretty much implemented that to this. I knew if I played good around here, I had a chance to win, and that's what I did.
So a different look on the leaderboard after each round here at Burning Tree Country Club, but O'Toole takes the last round, and that's the one that mattered most. Reporting in Decatur, Max Cohan, Way 31 Sports.